Hello aspirants, myself Kirtana Bhusa. I have appeared for interview in 2018. We at Narayana IAS Academy have come up with mains module to facilitate your answer writing. Important topics for the coming mains 2019 are picked and all the important points required to cover the topic are provided in a simple and lucid manner. We are taking these points from multiple sources so that you will get sufficient points to use in the mains exam. We are also taking extreme care to provide good structure to the topic. Hope our efforts will benefit you. Having said this, let us move to the topic today, land reforms. It is a part of your GS paper 3, economics. The government of India is aware that agricultural development in India could be achieved only through reform of India's rural institutional structure. The first 5-year plan stated that land reform is a fundamental issue of national importance. In the same way, the former Prime Minister Indira Gandhi emphasized land reforms is the most crucial test which our political system must pass in order to survive. So land reforms therefore became one of the vital aspects of the agricultural development policy, especially after the concept of the first 5-year plan came to stay. The main characteristics of agrarian structure which independent India inherited were absentee landlordism, tiny and fragmented land holding, unequal distribution of land, lack of adequate institutional finance and exploitation of tenants. This is what we have inherited at the time of our independence. The Jamindari system, Raitwari system, Mahalwari system which was introduced by the Britishers have not benefited Indian agriculture. In fact, they have created hurdles such as absentee landlordism, fragmented land holding, unequal distribution of land, as well as lack of adequate institutional finance and exploitation of tenants. As said by Bipin Chandra, because of the introduction of this Jamindari, Mahalwari and Raitwari system, the peasants were so impoverished that it continued even after the independence and they were debt ridden even till now. And what are the objectives of land reforms in India? The main objective is to enhance the productivity of the land by improving economic conditions of farmers and tenants so that they will have the interests to invest in and improve agriculture. So the first objective is to enhance the productivity of the land by improving the economic conditions of the farmers and tenants, and to ensure distributive justice and to create an egalitarian society. And land to the tiller, this is another important objective, that is peasant proprietorship, and transfer the incomes of the few to many. That is, this may lead to demand for consumer goods will be created and finally growth in the GDP. And what are the 4 types of experiments to alter the pattern of distribution? So in India, the land reforms, the first one is land reforms from above, that is through legislations by central and state government. And there is also another land reform from above, that is land grab movement. It has happened in Telangana and Naxalite movement. If one is through legislations by central and state government, the other land reform from above is land grab movement. While one is legal, the other is illegal. And land reforms through both legislative enactments, that is from above, as well as peasant mobilization, that is from below. It has happened in West Bengal as well as Kerala. And the 4th experiment is land reforms from below through permission of landlords and peaceful processions by peasants, as in case of Bhudan and Gramdhan movement. So there were 4 types of experiments with respect to land reforms in India. Land reform legislations were passed touching upon these measures, that is abolition of jamindaris, tenancy reforms to regulate fair rent and security to the tenure. So whenever land reform legislations were passed, they have taken the following factors into consideration, that is abolition of jamindaris, tenancy reforms to regulate fair rent and security to tenure, ceilings on land holdings and distribution of surplus among the landless, consolidation of land holdings and prevention of their further fragmentation. This has improved cropping intensity and remunerative cropping pattern, as well as decreased the cost of cultivation. This statement was given by Food and Agricultural Organization. Development of cooperative farming. So land reform legislations were passed touching upon these measures. That is cooperative farming, consolidation of land holding, ceilings on land holdings, tenancy reforms, as well as abolition of jamindaris. Then we look into the reasons why the efficacy of legislations has not been fruitful. One is binami holdings became the order of the day in many states. The act did not benefit subtenants and sharecroppers as they did not have occupancy rights on the land they cultivated. This is another reason. Tenancy reforms excluded the sharecroppers who form the bulk of tenant cultivators. So these tenancy reforms, they have not taken into consideration the sharecroppers who form the bulk of tenant cultivators. The right of resumption given in legislation has led to land grabbing by unscrupulous people. And the proof of cultivation or possession for 12 consecutive years to get occupancy rights led to tardy implementation of tenancy reforms. So there is a need of proof that they have been cultivating the land for 12 consecutive years to have these occupancy rights, and this led to tardy implementation of these tenancy reforms. Time consuming and complicated process in distribution of land. Many jamindars have resorted to courts, and this has been dragged for many years, and the process is complicated for the common man. So this is one of the reasons that the land reforms were not that successful in India. That is, they were time consuming as well as complicated. And the major hurdle is the bureaucratic corruption. There are many reasons for not these land reforms being successful. The other reason is the lack of adequate direction and determination among the stakeholders, lack of political will, ignorance and lack of pressure from below. The tenant farmers, the sharecroppers were ignorant, and due to the casteism in the society prevailing, there is a lack of pressure from below. Absence of correct updated land records and the lack of support also led to the decrease in efficacy of these legislations. Then we'll discuss what is the strategy to achieve success. These strategies were taken from Asian Development Bank recommendations as well as some of the recommendations in the Planning Commission website. Political commitment at the top, administrative preparedness including the improvement of technical design of enactments and creation of necessary supporting service for the beneficiaries. There should be a necessary support for the beneficiaries, and the Planning Commission also says that there is a need to organize the beneficiaries themselves. These people are scattered based on caste, religion as well as class, so there is a need for organization of beneficiaries. They should come collectively and fight for their rights, and for this to happen there should be awareness among them and proper leadership. So organization of beneficiaries themselves will have great impact on the success of land reforms. Simplifying the legal procedures as they are complicated and leading to time consuming process, there is a need to simplify the legal procedures. Effective implementation of ceiling legislation and distribution of surplus land. There is a need to implement these ceiling legislations so that the landlords will not resort to binami land holdings and breaking up landlord-tenant nexus. Then what is the positive impact of land reforms in India? The powerful jamindars and jagirdars have become inexistent, as one of the aim of land reform is abolition of jamindari system. So we can say that to some extent we are successful, as powerful jamindars as well as jagirdars have become inexistent. The abolition of intermediaries has stopped exploitation. Since there were no intermediaries, there was no exploitation, and the new proprietorship has given scope for innovation in land reforms. Since the concept of land to tiller has come, and the new proprietorship has given scope for them to innovate in their land, that ownership has given them that enthusiasm to go and innovate in their own lands, and transfer of land to peasants from intermediaries has reduced disparities to some extent. We were not totally successful, but we were able to reduce these disparities to some extent. The work of consolidation in Punjab and Haryana has seen positive results in terms of production. Let us look into the negative impact. The ownership of land has not yet been fully transferred to the tillers, and the actual rents still rule high Consolidation of land holdings has not been completed only in few areas such as Punjab and Haryana. Consolidation of land holdings has happened and cooperative farming has not made much headway. There is marked unevenness in respect of progress in various states. There is regional disparities in implementation of these land reforms. These are some of the negative impacts. Then we'll move to conclusion. The two barriers that hinder the implementation are ignorance of the poor and selfishness of the rich. These are the two barriers that hinder the implementation of land reforms in a successful manner. Hence, one of the recommendations of the Planning Commission is organization of the beneficiaries. So, it's the responsibility of the government as well as the civil society to bring awareness among the poor about their respective rights so that they will mobilize themselves to fight for their rights. In order to remove these barriers, the poor should be motivated through persuasion and education. Rich should be compelled to cooperate. Then only the success of these land reforms, which our freedom fighters have thought would be fruitful. This requires a government with a strong political will and bureaucracy with commitment. So for the success of the land reforms, four sections of the people are important. One is the poor, one is the rich who are holding large amount of land, as well as the political will and bureaucracy. Land reforms is an important topic. Questions were asked in previous years from this section. Even though it is a static part, please have few points. Have a holistic understanding of the complete topic so that whatever the question might come, you will be able to have the points required to write your answer. Hope this video is helpful. Keep answer writing practice daily. Thank you and all the best.